everyone! Today I'm presenting you a flawless and exemplary rental application. So, without wasting any minutes, let us hop into the application. To begin with, towards the left we have the entire admin panel and towards the right we have our application. You will have comprehensive access to managing the application via the admin panel, hence you possess absolute ownership of the app. So, let us now explore each and every section in syncage of the application simultaneously. Thereby, we will start with the dashboard. The dashboard brings you multifarious functionalities. From here, you can have a clear view of the total users, total booking requests, bookings of the day, and total listings precisely. Besides this, you will get a detailed graphical representation of the user as well as the total booking ratio. On top of that, you can also filter and check the data for both users and bookings in light of a daily basis, weekly basis, monthly basis, or even the yearly basis. Next up, we have the Manage Role section. Basically, you can assign this application to a sub-admin and the admin can manage the app simultaneously. However, you need to filter and add the arenas that a sub-admin shall manage. As we can see that we have a clear display of the sub-admin's name along with the permissions granted, and you also get an action button from where you can edit or delete a sub-admin whenever you want. On top of that, you can add as many sub-admins as you want. You simply need to click on the Add Role section, put in the name, select certain roles, submit, and a new sub-admin is set with the new roles now. Moving further, now we have the Manage Sub-admin section. This section is arranged to provide you the authority of managing your sub-admin. We can see that you have a clear display of the sub-admin's name, the email address, the phone number, the role, the status, along with an action button from where you can view, edit, or delete a sub-admin at your convenience. On top of that, you will find a search option from where you can search for a sub-admin manually, and you can set the status into inactive or active. Apart from that, you will find the role section from where you can set the permission according to the roles that we set previously in the role section, and then you can apply the changes or clear the same. Moving further, you can also set a new sub-admin manually. You simply need to fill in the details and then you are good to go. Thereby, let us now sign into the application and comprehend all the sections of the admin panel with much precision. Both the users and the host can operate from a similar application, so let us sign up now. We first need to fill in the email address. We need to then fill in the phone number. Then we'll have to set a password. Confirm the password. Now we'll go for the sign up. The app will want to verify your information, so let us go with the phone. Now we need to wait for an OTP. Let's fill in the OTP. Now you need to set your profile. Firstly, you'll have to set your first name, your last name, then your email address and your phone number will be inbuilt. You need to set a birth date and then the country or the state. Here we go. Let's proceed. Next, you can see that your profile is created, and from here you can have a clear glimpse when we go for the manage user section that the new profile is added here simultaneously. Thereby, creating a user profile in our rental application was this simple. Now, since we told you that from this application you will be able to function like a host as well as a user at the same time, so let us now see how being a host works. For that, we will go to My Listings. Go to Add Properties. Over here you can see that become a host as an option, which means that if you fill in the details, your property will be listed and you will be set up as a host. So let us now fill in the details. By filling in certain details, we will start with the listing's nickname, the pricing, we'll select the property type, the property's characteristics. Now we have the property size, the location. Moving further, We will select the amenities that we wish to provide our users with. Next up, we have the activities area, like the activities that you wish to provide your users with. Moving forward, now we need to set a properties description. Then we have to select some answers. Now, we have the properties rules and restrictions. So when you become a host, there are certain rules and regulations that you want your users to follow. So we will be selecting those. These are all customized and can be done according to you and according to your convenience. Each and every answer is mandatory to be fulfilled. Let's keep going. The garbage bins, every answer is important. Moving forward, now we have the hunting and fishing protocols. You need to select all of those. You have certain important criteria and verticals that you need to fill: the experience, the lodging details, the discount that you want to provide, the start and end date, the minimum stay, advance notice, so we will put it as 1, blackout date, okay. Then we have to select the bookability. Now we are good to go. Now we need to upload a picture. Now set in a featured image. For that, we'll be clicking a random picture. We'll proceed with the property pictures first. Now we need to upload the license. Here we go. So now you are listed your property in a very precise manner, and you can term yourself as a host now. So let us get back to the manage user section. Well, this is yet another intriguing feature of our application, because from here you will get a comprehensive view of the user's details along with managing them simultaneously. You will get a clear view of the user's name, the email address, the phone number, address, and the total bookings. Now, the total bookings here means the total number of bookings that the host has listed on the site. And then we have the complete bookings, which means the bookings that have been availed by the user. Besides this, we have the total trips, which means the total number of trips booked by the user. Further, we have the complete trips, which denotes the bookings availed by the user. Furthermore, we have the wallet, which lets you see the balance left for your user. And finally, we have the action button, which lets you view, edit, or delete a user simultaneously. Now we have the manage activities section. Basically, the activities that we found while setting up our profile can be managed from here. We can see that the activities that we chose, here they are: fishing, camping, bird watching, archery, and more. So all these activities are present over here. You can either edit, delete, add new activities, and the same changes will be portrayed over here. Now, for example, if we delete the fishing category from here, you will see that this will vanish from this side as well. Here you go. We don't have the fishing anymore over here. Similarly, we can add fishing again, and it will be available here simultaneously. Moving further, next up we have the manage categories section, where you can sort all the categories, check the date when it was created, edit or delete one if needed, and add new ones as well. These characteristics play a very important role, as these are the geographical dimensions only where a host can list their bookings. Next up we have the manage gift card section. Here you can manage the gift cards added by the host comprehensively. You will get the details of the gift card along with the option of managing the toggle button of the status and putting it to active or inactive as per your choice. You will find the gift card section precisely in the settings. Let's have a check. Here you go. And finally, we have the edit or delete the gift card option. Besides this, you can also add new gift cards if you wish to and search for gift cards and apply to them simultaneously. The total number of gift cards will also be available to you. Now we have the manage booking section. So from here, you will have a clear glimpse of the entire data, starting from the customer's information, the host information, the listing's name, the booking ID, the guest count, the amount, the service charges, the discount, the total amount taken, the status of the payment type, the status if the trip or the ride is completed, cancelled, rejected or accepted, when it was created, along with the action button from where you will have a comprehensive view of the entire booking details. Next up, we have the manage amenities section. So for that, we'll first go to the amenities section in the application first. Here we go. So from here, you get the hold of amenity management as per the name, as per the amenity category, when it was created, and you can edit or delete the amenity as per your convenience and add new ones as usual. You can see that you have the categories along with the specialty of the names specifically. Similarly, now comes the manage earnings section. From here, you can avail the data about the total bookings and the total earnings. Besides this, you will also have a clear data on the earnings process by the host also. Next up, we have the manage listings. From this section, you can have a clear note on all the listings made by a varied host. You can have access of the data starting from the listing's nickname, the property's location, the pricing per day, the acres of the land, the status, if the listing is active or not. You will have the action button from where you can view, edit or delete a listing. You can search for a listing specifically, apply or clear the changes, and export the CSV file as per your convenience also. Furthermore, we have the manage rewards section from where you can manage the rewards availed by the customers precisely. From the reward list, you can get a detailed data about the customers availing the rewards, starting from the customer's name, the total amount spent, the reward points, along with the date when the reward was created is also visible here. And in the reward settings section, you will find the option to select the amount which will qualify the user to earn the reward, along with the total number of reward points in a very precise manner. You can change the settings according to your convenience also. Moving forward, we all know that the online reputation owns due importance for every venture. Therefore, our application gives you the authority to manage the reviews systematically. You will have a clear glimpse of the complete review details, starting from the booking ID, the user's name, the campsite name, that is the site's name, the rating, the review itself, along with an action button from where you can delete the review anytime you want. Similarly, knowing the revenue generated by your application is one of the most integral powers. Thereby, the app gives you a clear glimpse of the total card payments, wallet payments, and the total revenue as a whole. Besides this, the entire information of the ID, the customer's name, the host name, the commission taken, the total amount spent, along with the payment method is also accessible to you. Next up, we have the manage reporting section. Well, again, we know frauds and scams are at their peak these days. Therefore, you will have the complete option to check the reported listings with clear scrutiny. You will have access to the booking ID, the land name, the user's name, the reason for the report, and the name of the individual who reported comprehensively. Further, we have the broadcast notifications. From here, you can send the notifications to the user and host all together. You just need to write the title of the notification, type the message, submit, and you're good to go. Apart from that, when we come to the application, you just need to go to the settings. And from here, you can enable the toggle button for notifications. If you enable it, you will get the notification. If you do not, you will not get it, vice versa. Next up, we have the settings section. From here, you can manage the settings of the application and the way it will be portrayed all around. You can manage the referral points per user, the service tax that you want to charge, the service charges, the app store's link, the supported email, the contact address, the supported phone number, the LinkedIn link, the Facebook link, the YouTube link, the Instagram link, and the Play Store link, submit it, and then you're good to go. Moving further, now we have the analytics section. Here you can have a clear overview of your earnings. You can also sort and view the earnings according to the day, week, month, or even the year comprehensively. Finally, now we have reached the last section of our application. This is known as the Manage CMS section. From here, you can manage the FAQs comprehensively. All this will be shown in the application. However, you can edit, delete, and add new FAQs anytime you want. And all these FAQs will be present here. We can have a clear glimpse. And this was all about our rental app admin panel and the application as well. As you can see that it was extremely simple to use. Therefore, if you're planning to launch your own rental platform, I recommend you to click on the link in the description and assist us in getting this panel ready for your business. You can also email us the details or DM us on our social media accounts. Thank you.